Oh, hey, Div.
Hey, Jeremy.
Would you mind answering 33 questions for why Ryerson?
Obviously, let's go.
Awesome, walk with me.
Cool.
So, to start things off, what program and year are you in?
I am in aerospace engineering and I am in my fourth year.
What's your favorite aerospace engineering course that you've taken?
So my favorite one is the one I'm currently taking. It's called Orbital Dynamics.
Out of the three different streams in aerospace engineering, why did you choose to focus on spacecraft over aircraft or avionics?
I chose spacecraft because I love everything about rockets, spaceships, spacecrafts, and in general, everything about space. So that's why I chose spacecraft.
What intrigues you the most about space?
How vast it is, how empty it is, how much of it is unexplored. As humans, it's tendency for us to explore all of these things, and that's why I love space.
Would you ever consider being an astronaut?
It's funny you ask that question, because the reason why I joined aerospace engineering was because I wanted to be an astronaut since I was 3 years old.
Speaking of astronauts, I hear that there's one coming to the George Very Innovation Conference.
Yes, yes. Chris Hadfield is coming to Ryerson soon. Tickets start at $20.
Is everybody allowed to come see Chris Hadfield?
Yes. Everyone is allowed to come to. It's open to all of Ryerson and all of Toronto as well. And yes, as I said before, tickets start at $20.
What do you admire most about Chris Hadfield?
About Chris Hadfield, I love how open he is, how much of a people person he is, how loving he is, and how much he does for the community.
So what is the George Very Innovation Conference, or GVIC?
So the George Very Innovation Conference is a conference that is for students who are innovative, for entrepreneurship, and students who want to get involved and know everything about the tech and innovative sector.
What's your position at GVIC?
This year I'm the co-chair.
As an engineering student, what made you also want to attend the Ted Rogers Management Conference?
So the Ted Rogers Management Conference is a conference based on business management. One of the things as engineers, we are very technical, but we really don't learn about the business aspects. And that's one of the things why I went to Ted Rogers Management Conference, to learn about the business aspects about different things.
So you've attended countless other conferences. Who would you say was the most memorable speaker?
So the most memorable speaker, I would say, I met at Connect IT, and it was Sebastian from Deloitte. He talked about different things such as building your own brand, how to build your own company, etc.
Can you share your experience competing in Ryerson's next top speaker?
So Ryerson's next top speaker was a really cool competition. It's where different speakers from all around campus compete for one coveted prize. I came in the second place. One of the things that you learn is what's going on in the background with students, what is their story, and that's why I love competing in Ryerson's Next Top Speaker.
What's it like being president of REST, Ryerson Engineering Student Society?
Being president of REST is very stressful, very time-consuming, but I love it because I get to meet all the engineering students, know about their situations, know about their problems, and actually get to help them out as well.
What does REST do for engineering students?
So, REST is the Ryerson Engineering Student Society, and for students, it caters to all engineering students. It does events for them, different academic tutorials, helps them in every situation since the day they arrive at Ryerson as an engineer.
Who are the RAM guards?
Oh, so the RAM guards are frost eaters who are here to protect the RAM, which is our mascot, as well as the golden hard hat, which the president wears during spirited events.
What's your favorite engineering tradition?
My favorite engineering tradition is obviously purpling. The purpling is an age-old tradition which comes from the fact when engineers on the Titanic kept dumping coal to make the Titanic stay afloat for the longest time. And they wore purple bands which bled on their hands and gave a purple dyeing effect. So that's why we do use the purple tie as a memory to them.
Can you tell us something that REST has in store for students this year?
So one of the most exciting things is REST is introducing a really new lineup of merchandise. It's merchandise that everyone can wear in and out of school, and I'm very excited for the release.
Why is it important for students to involve themselves on campus?
I feel like students being involved on campus helps them network, helps them meet new people, and according to me, your network is your net worth.
I understand that you also have a photography hobby. What's something that you love to capture?
I love photography. I do a lot of shoots here and then whenever I get the time. I think one of the things I love most about photography and capturing is people. I love capturing people in their natural habitat. I love capturing their smiles, and I love capturing their emotions.
What do you think is the most useful tip for balancing time?
Google Calendar. Google Calendar is your best friend. You can literally put anything on it. I put my meetings, my labs, my study times, when I'm going to a party, and even when I'm just having some downtime.
You also decided to pursue several minors. Which ones were they?
So, there were marketing, entrepreneurship, and math.
Why did you decide to do the entrepreneurship minor?
In the future, I do want to build on my startup and build my own company. And I feel like the entrepreneurship startup really helped me learn those aspects to how to get started up.
You're an international student, correct?
Yes, I am.
So, if I were to ask you, in your opinion, what's something you love about Canada that your home country doesn't have, what would you say?
I think the people. Everyone's very friendly, very accepting, and I love that about Canada.
What's the best thing about being specifically in Toronto?
Oh, Toronto. I feel like it's so fast-paced, so bustling. Everyone's really like, go, go, go. I am of the same nature, and I really love that fact.
In your opinion, what's your favorite nightclub in Toronto?
My favorite nightclub is Cube. I love going to Cube. It's always a good time. I've never had a bad time at Cube.
In the previous summer, you managed to visit 5 provinces in 5 days. What was the highlight of your trip?
So I visited 5 provinces, which were Ontario, Quebec, Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and PEI. The highlight of the event was obviously going to PEI, taking the Confederation Bridge. It was amazing. It was all fog around, and it literally looked like a stairway to heaven.
Where's your favorite place to be on campus?
My favorite place to be on campus is the rest office after 9 p.m. It's so quiet, so peaceful. I get a lot of my work done after that time, and it's also good for my downtime.
Do you have a plan for what you want to do after graduation?
After graduation, I want to build on my startup, as well as I want to join the aerospace sector.
What will you miss most about Ryerson?
I'm going to miss the social aspect. I'm going to miss meeting people. I'm going to miss meeting everyone. I think the social aspect is what I'm going to miss most about Ryerson.
Last question, why Ryerson?
So the reason why I chose to come to Ryerson is because Ryerson's always given me everything I wanted to do. It's given me a platform. It's never stopped me. It's always supported my projects. And that's why I'm glad I came to Ryerson.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time, Div.
Cool. Thank you, Jeremy.
Bye.